Holy, 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 the Holy Gospel according to St. John, may his blessings be with us all. Amen.
When the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, and the Father, the Son of my name, has come, he shall teach you all things and make you remember all things that I have said unto you. My peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you. Not as the world gives, but I give unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. You have heard how I said unto you, I go away, and come again unto you. If you love me, you may rejoice, because I said, I go unto the Father, for my Father is greater than I. Now I have told you before it comes to pass, that when it comes to pass, you might believe. I'm not talking much with you, for the prince of this world comes and has nothing in me, but that the world may know that I love the Father, and the Father gave me commandment. So I do arise, let us go from here. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. Every branch that bears fruit, he prunes, that it may bring forth more fruit. Let it cling to the word which I have spoken unto you, by me and I you.
Glory be to God forever. Amen. May the saying of God be fulfilled in peace. The Lord be with Christos and return of the souls. Remember no man from where she appeared, so to you, O man. Your Holy Spirit, O Lord, whom you sent forth upon your holy disciples and honored apostles in the third hour, do not take away from us, good one, but renew them with us, created me a clean heart, O God, and renew our spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit away from me. O Lord, who sent down your Holy Spirit upon your holy disciples and your honored apostles in the third hour, do not take him away from us, good one, but we ask you to renew him within us, O Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, the Word, a right and life-giving spirit, a spirit of prophecy and chastity, a spirit of wholeness, righteousness, and authority, O the Almighty One, for you are the light of our souls, O you give light to every man that comes in the world, have mercy on us. O Theotokos, you are the true vine, who bore the cluster of life, we ask you full of grace with the apostles, for the salvation of our souls, blessed is the Lord our God, blessed is the Lord, day by day he prepares our way, for he is God of our salvation.
O heavenly King, the Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, was present in all places in person, the treasury of good things and the life giver, graciously commend within us and purifies from all defilement to good one, and save our souls. Just as you were with your disciples, O Savior, and gave them peace, graciously come also and be with us and grant us your grace and save us and deliver us our souls. Whenever we stand in your holy sanctuary, we are considered standing in heaven. O Theotokos, you are the gate of heaven. Open for us the gate of mercy.
Holy God, holy one, holy one. Worthy to be thanked, our Father who art in heaven. Hail to you, rescue is made full of glory. Holy, 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 the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew. May his blessings be with us all. Amen.
Help the world, Lord. Glory be to you.
Amen.
the Virgin, we praise you, for through the cross of your Son, Hades fell down and death was abolished. We were dead, but we were raised and became worthy of eternal life and gained the delight of the first paradise. Before we thankfully glorify the immortal Christ our God,
we exalt you, the Mother of the true life. Church of God. Amen. Remember, O Lord, those who have brought to you these gifts, those on whose behalf they have been brought, and those by whom they have been brought. Give them all the heavenly reward.
May for these holy and precious gifts our sacrifices, and those who have brought them, Lord, have mercy.
Alleluia.
Amen.
serpents and scorpions, and upon all the power of the air.
absolved from the mouth of the All-Holy Trinity, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and from the mouth of the one only Holy, Catholic and Apostolic Orthodox Church of God, from the mouth of the 12 Apostles, from the mouth of the Beholder of God, St. Mark is a pure apostle and evangelist, Patriarch St. Severus, our teacher and scholars, St. Athanasius Apostolic, St. Peter the Holy Martyr and the Archpriest, St. Chrysostom, St. Cyril, St. Basil, St. Gregory, from the mouth of the 318 assembled at Nicaea, 150 at Constantinople, 200 at Ephesus, from the mouth of our honored father, the Archpriest, Baba Abba Tawadros, from my own mouth being the least, for bliss and for the glory is your holy name, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, now and forever, on the age of ages. Amen.
So, 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 so
Take heed how he builds on it. For no other foundation can anyone lay than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Now if anyone builds on this foundation with gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, straw, each one's work will become clear. For the day will declare, because it will be revealed by fire, and the fire will test each one's work, of what sort it is. If anyone's work which he has built on it endures, he will receive a reward. If anyone's work is burned, he will suffer loss, but he himself will be saved, yet so as through fire. Do you not know that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If anyone defiles the temple of God, God will destroy him. For the temple of God is holy, whose temple are you. Let no one deceive himself. If anyone among you seems to be wise in this age, let him become a fool, that he may become wise. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness with God. For it is written, he catches the wise in their own craftiness. And then, and again, the Lord knows the thoughts of the wise, that they are futile. Therefore, let no one boast in that, for all things are yours. Whether Paul or Apollos or Cephas or the world or life or death or things present or things to come, all are yours, and you are Christ, and Christ is God's. The grace of God the Father be with you all. Amen.
The Catholic epistle from the first epistle of our teacher Saint Peter, may the holy blessings be with us all. Amen. Likewise, you younger people, submit yourselves to your elders. Yes, all of you be submissive to one another, and be clothed with humility, for God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Therefore, humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt in you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walks about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. Resist him, steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same sufferings are experienced by your brotherhood in the world. But may the God of all grace, who called us to his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after you have suffered a while, perfect, establish, strengthen, and settle you. To him be the glory and the dominion forever and ever. Amen. By Silvanus, our faithful brother, as I consider him, I have written to you briefly, exhorting and testifying that this is the true grace of God in which you stand. She who is in Babylon, elect together with you, greets you, so does Mark my son. Greet one another with a kiss of love. Peace to you all who are in Christ Jesus. Amen. Do not love the world or the things in the world. The world is passing away in its lust. He who does the will of God abides forever.
Yeah. Amen. Now a certain Jew named Apollos, born at Alexandria, an eloquent man and mighty in the scriptures, came to Ephesus. This man had been instructed in the way of the Lord, and being fervent in spirit, he spoke and taught accurately the things of the Lord, only the baptism of John. So he began to speak boldly in the synagogue. When Aquila and Priscilla heard him, they took him aside and explained to him the way of God more accurately. And when he desired to cross to Achaia, the brethren wrote exhorting the disciples to receive him. And when he arrived, he greatly helped those who had believed through grace. For he vigorously refuted the Jews publicly, showing them the scriptures that Jesus is the Christ. And it happened while Apollos was at Corinth that Paul, having passed through the upper regions, came to Ephesus, and finding some disciples, he said to them, "Do you receive the Holy Spirit when you believe?" So they said to him, "You have not so much as heard whether there is a Holy Spirit." And he said to them, "Into what then were you baptized?" So they said, "Into John's baptism." Then Paul said, "John indeed baptized with a baptism of repentance, saying to the people that they should believe on him who would come after him, that is, on Christ Jesus." When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul had laid hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke with the tongues and prophesied. The word of the Lord shall grow and multiply, be mighty, and be confirmed in the Holy Church of God. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, on God, Amen. Today is the 14th day of the blessed month of Tuba. May God start in goodness, may He renew for us for many years in peaceful times, while our sins and iniquities are forgiven through the tender mercies of our merciful Lord.
On this day, Saint Archimedes departed. This fighter was born in the city of Rome. His father's name was John, and his mother's name was Cincinnatique. They were righteous before the Lord and lived according to his commandments. The saint's father died when he was 12 years old. When his mother wanted him to get married, he declined. She advised him to go to the emperor to take over his father's position. She sent along with him two of their men and a precious gift to present to the emperor. While they were sailing, they encountered a great tempest with high waves and strong winds, so that the ship was wrecked. The saint hung onto one of the ship's planks, and God saved him from drowning. When he made it to the seashore, he found a body of a dead man that was thrown to the shore. He reflected on the transience of the world and its temporal nature, and said to himself, "What do I have to do with this temporal world? And what would I profit when I die and become dust?" He arose and prayed to the Lord Christ to guide him to the right way. Then he walked diligently until he arrived at the monastery of Saint Romanus. He gave to the abbot of the monastery what was left of his money. He stayed there, living an ascetic life, denying himself food and clothing until he reached a level of perfection. The Lord granted him the gift of healing the sick. He made an oath not to ever see the face of any woman. When he did not return to his mother for a long time, and she did not know his whereabouts, she thought that he died, and she grieved much over him. She built a hostel for the poor and the strangers, and she lived in one of its rooms. One day she heard the two merchants talking about her son and his holy monastic life and the grace of God that was upon him. When she inquired about him, she became sure that it was him, her own son. She arose quickly and went to that monastery. When she arrived, she sent to inform the saint of her arrival. sent Archimedes answered her, saying that he had made an oath before God not to ever see a woman. She repeated her request and threatened that if he did not allow her to see him, she would go to the wilderness to be eaten by the wild beasts. When he learned of her persistence and that he could not renegade from his oath, he prayed to the Lord Christ to take his soul. Then he told the gatekeeper to allow her to come in. While God had answered his request, when his mother entered his cell, she found that he had given up his spirit. She cried, wept, and asked God to take her soul also, and God answered her prayer. When they tried to separate their bodies, they heard a voice coming from Saint Archimedes' body saying, "Let my body be with the body of my mother, for I did not grant her own heart's desire to see me." They buried both of them in one grave. God honored this saint in performing many miracles. May his prayers be with us all. Amen. On this day also Saint Maximus, the brother of Saint Ovidius, departed. They were the children of Emperor Valdivianus. Their prayers be with us all, and glory be to our God forever. Amen.
The Lord.
is in his heart, and his steps shall not slide.
Behind his parable.
There are two questions usually people ask about this cup. The first question, how the master commended the unjust steward. As you heard in the parable, he called the debtors of his master and he asked the first one, how much do you owe your master? He told him 100 measures of oil. He told him, write 50. The second one told him, how do you owe my master? So he told him 80 or 100 measures of wheat. So he said to him, take your bill and write 80. So how the master commends this behavior, it's wrong behavior. There are actually two ways to understand and to answer this question. The first way that each steward actually had a commission. So he, when he told him, write 50 instead of 100, or write 80 instead of 100, he actually did not take his commission. In order to make friendship with these people, so when he actually leaves the stewardship, these people can actually help him to live or to find another job, etc. So he did not actually take from his master's money, but from his own commission. That's one way to understand it. The other way to understand it, that he was not honest with his master's money. Yes, he was not honest. But the master did not commend his dishonesty, because we cannot commend dishonesty. But he commended how he planned for his future, how he actually tried to secure a good future for him, for himself, after he leaves the stewardship. For example, if a thief steals a bank, but in a very smart way, and he was not able, or he did not leave any evidence behind him to tell the police or the investigators who the thief was. So when we read the story, we maybe commend the thief in his intelligence, how he was very smart in planning. So we are not commending the act of theft or stealing money, but we are commending here the intelligence, how he was smart. That's why the Lord said that the sons of this world are more shrewd in their generation than the sons of light. Meaning what? Meaning this unjust steward, he planned for his future when he leaves as a stewardship. But we children of light, are we planning for our eternal future? You can see here people plans for future in general. They have life insurance, retirement plan, and several types of insurance. So they insure their car, they insure their properties, they insure their health. So if something happened to them, the insurance will cover. But how much planning we did for our eternal life? Here we live how many years? 90, 100 years? Maximum. But how did we plan for our eternal life, which is infinite, everlasting, no end for it? So the sons of this world plan for their future, but we don't plan for our heavenly future. That's why the Lord said, the sons of this world are more shrewd in their generation than the sons of light. So the message or the lesson we learn from this person, how he was able to make friends, even with unjust money. I'm not telling you make friends by stealing money from somebody else. No, I'm not saying this. But he planned for his future. So the message we should plan also for our eternal future. The second question that's usually is asked about this parable, when the Lord told us, and I say to you, make friends for yourself by unrighteous mammon, that when you fail, they may receive you into everlasting reputation. So the question, what is unrighteous mammon? What is unrighteous mammon? And again, there are two ways to understand this. The first way, everything we have here on earth is considered unrighteous because it is cursed since the fall of Adam and Eve. Yes, when we pray over it, it will be sanctified. But in a way, everything here is considered unrighteous. If we compare it with the riches in heaven, that's why the Lord said, if you have not been faithful in the unrighteous mammon, who will commit your trust to the true riches? What are the true riches? The true riches is the inheritance of the kingdom of God. Because it is totally pure. There is no sin. There is no corruption. There is nothing to defile the kingdom of heaven. Nothing. So this is the true riches. What we have here is corruptible. If you have food, for example, and you leave it for some days, it will be rotten. So there is corruptibility here. So it's called unrighteous man. That's one way. But there is another way. Who among us can say that all my money is 100% righteous? Do you work faithfully for your money? Don't you waste any moments or any minutes in your work? So do you believe what you get is 100% what you deserve? Nobody can claim this. Nobody can say, I am faithful in my work 100%. All of us waste time. All of us, we use work sometimes for personal benefits. So nobody can claim that what we have is 100% just and fair. Nobody can claim this. So in a way, what we have also is considered unrighteous because we are not faithful 100%, and also because everything here on earth is susceptible to corruptibility. So these are the two questions, and I hope I answered them, and the answer is clear. So let us see why the Lord actually told us this parable. What's the message behind this parable? What the Lord wants us to benefit from this parable? Number one, the principle of stewardship. The Lord wants to tell us what you have here on earth is not yours. You are just a steward. We were born naked. And when we die, we will not take one penny with us. So we came to this world without nothing, and we leave this world without nothing. So all what we have here is just a gift from God as a steward. We need to manage it for the glory of God. Your money, your time, your intelligence, your gifts, your talents, everything you have is not yours. You are just a steward. You are not the owner. You are not the owner. You are just a steward. That's the first principle. Second principle, with stewardship comes what? Accountability. So one day, all of us will stand before God, and God will tell you, give an account of your stewardship. I give you time, that much, 80 years, 90 years, 100 years. Were you faithful in this 100 years? How did you live your life? Did you waste your time? Or did you use your time faithfully? Your money, how you use it? Your gifts, how you use it, your mind and your thoughts, how you use it, your energy, your health, how you use it. Give an account of your stewardship. A smart person actually will give an account of his stewardship every day. Every day, stand before God and give account of his stewardship. And when he goes to confess his sins, again he will give account for his stewardship. So when I die, how many days I need to give an account? Only one day, is the last day. But can you imagine a person has business and he never did any accounting, then the IRS starts to do audit, he will be in big trouble because he never did any budget or balance sheet or account. But another person who actually is faithful and wise and make his accounts balancing every day, so when they told him you have an audit, he will not be troubled. He's ready. Come and audit my business. I know what I'm doing. So are you ready? Do you hold yourself accountable every day? And the third lesson here, what are the requirements in any steward, if you are a steward? What God is looking for? God is looking for two things in any steward: faithfulness and wisdom. As he said, who is the wise and faithful steward? Wisdom in order to manage your talents wisely, but heavenly wisdom, not earthly wisdom. And faithfulness in order not to steal the profit yourself, but to render it to God. Wisdom and faithfulness. Can you imagine if you have your own business and you want to hire a manager? What you are looking for in this manager? Number one, to be wise. Because if he's not wise, he will not make any profit. And number two, to be faithful. So he will not steal the profit from you. If you have a manager who is wise, very wise, but not faithful, yes, he will make profit, but he will not see anything. What about if he is faithful, but not wise? Yes, he will not steal your money, but he's not going to make any profit. You will lose your business. That's why the Lord said, who is the wise and faithful steward? So God expects from each one of us to be wise and faithful. How to deal with your money, how to deal with your time, how to deal with your talents, etc. Then the fourth lesson the Lord wants us to learn. This steward in this parable, he planned for his future. And how he did plan for his future? He made friends, he made connections. So when he leaves his stewardship, these friends will help him, give him money, host him in their houses, help him to find a job, anything. So the Lord told us, you also, you need to make friends for yourself by unrighteous mammon. And we define unrighteous mammon, anything you have here is considered unrighteous. So make friends for yourself by unrighteous mammon, that when you fail, they may receive you into everlasting heritage. When you help the poor with your money, you are making friends. And the poor actually will intercede on your behalf. Why? Because the Lord said, blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. All of us, when we remember the judgment day in the divine liturgy, we respond and say, according to your mercy, O Lord, and not according to our sins. How can you ask the mercies of the Lord if you yourself are unmerciful? How can you obtain mercy if you yourself is unmerciful? Show mercy first, that you will obtain mercy. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. And during the Holy Great Fast, we say, blessed is the merciful on the poor. mercy will dwell in them and will come upon them. So, show mercy. Show mercy from your money. Show mercy when you go and ask about a sick person and you help him. Show mercy about and go and listen to him and comfort him. Show mercy when you encourage a person who actually feels stressed out. Show mercy when you give a smile to a person who feels depressed or unhappy. We have responsibility toward one another, to encourage one another, to love one another. Make friends for yourself with God, what God gave you here, with all your talents, money, time, intelligence, effort, etc. Make friends that when you fail, you may receive, they may receive you into everlasting habitation. So the Lord told us, he who is faithful in what is least is faithful in also in much. What's what least? What we have here on earth is considered least. If you compare it with the true riches in the everlasting life, what you have here is considered least. So, are you faithful in what's least? If you are not faithful in what's least, who will give to you what's much? That's why the Lord told us. And therefore, if you have not been faithful in what's least, who will give you as much? And then the Lord told us another thing. And who is, if you have not been faithful in the unrighteous mammon, who will commit to your trust the true riches? And if you have been not faithful in what is another man's, who will give you what's your own? Another man's, because as I told you, we are not owners, we are stewards. So if we are not faithful on what we have here, knowing it is not ours, who will give you what's your own? Maybe you can say, but that's what my own. It's my own. So why actually I cannot get it, whether I am faithful or not? But let me tell you, what's your own is given to you as a free gift, not because you earned it. You can make this argument if you earned it, but you did not earn it. Like, for example, if parents have a large sum of inheritance to their children, huge amount of money, but one of their children is living his life irresponsibly. He's wasting his money, he's wasting his time, everything. He's irresponsible. So do you think they will give him his inheritance? They will say no. Because if we give him this large sum of money, he will waste it just like this. So they may put it in a trust account or whatever in order to protect the money and to protect their son. What is our own? It is gift, free gift from God to us. We did not earn it. When we accepted the Lord Jesus Christ to be our God, then we became children of God the Father. And since we are children, then we will inherit the kingdom of God. Because God adopted us, not because we are children of nature. So if a parent, if a family adopted a son, and this son is living irresponsible, do you think they will give their inheritance to him? No. That's why the Lord told us, and if you have not been faithful in what is another man's, who will give you what's your own? So we need to show faithfulness. So this parable is about stewardship, accountability, faithfulness, and wisdom, and planning for your future. These are the main lessons in this parable. I hope that we can understand these lessons, and we know we are not owners, we are stewards. We one day will give accountability for our stewardship. We are required to be faithful and wise, and also we should plan for our eternal future when making friends. As the Lord told us, make friends for yourself by unrighteous mammon, that when you fail, they may receive you into everlasting habitation. May the Lord grant us to be faithful and wise in all the talents, in all the responsibility that He gave us in order to glorify His holy name in everything. Glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.
Of your one only holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
Pray for the peace of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Orthodox Church of God.
Glory and mercy.
This which exists from one end of the world to the other, all peoples and all flocks bless. The heavenly peace send down into all our hearts, even the peace of this life also graciously grant to us, the leader, the army, the ruler, the counselors, the multitudes, our neighbors, our coming in and our going out, adorn them with all peace. O King of peace, grant us your peace, for you have given us all things. Acquire us yourself, O God, our Savior, for we know none other but you. Your holy name we utter. May our souls live by your Holy Spirit, and let not the death of sins have dominion over us, we your servants, nor over all your people.
Glory and mercy.
As God the Pantocrator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind. Remember, O Lord, our honored father, the archpriest, our patriarch, Abba Tawadros II, and his spiritual brethren, the Patriarch of Antioch, Mar Ignatius Ephraim II, and the Patriarch of Eritrea, Abuna Antonius, and his partner in the Apostolic Liturgy, our Father the Bishop, Abba Youssef.
Pray for our High Priest, Pope Abba Tawadros, Pope and Patriarch and Archbishop of the Greek city of Alexandria, and his spiritual brothers, the Patriarch of Antioch, Mar Ignatius Ephraim II, and the Patriarch of Eritrea, Abuna Antonius I, and his partner in the Apostolic Liturgy, our Father, the Bishop Abba Youssef, and for Orthodox bishops.
Lord, have mercy.
Keep them secure for us for many years and peaceful times, fulfilling that holy high priesthood with which you have entrusted them for yourself, according to your holy and blessed will. Rightly dividing the word of truth, shepherding your people in purity and righteousness, and all the Orthodox bishops, ignomens, priests, and deacons, and all the fullness of your one only holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. Grant them and us in peace and safety in every place their prayers which they offer on our behalf.
And on behalf of all your people,
as well as ours on their behalf, receive upon your holy rational altar of heaven as a sweet savor of incense all their enemies, visible and invisible, trample and humiliate under their feet speedily. As for them, keep them in peace and righteousness in your holy church.
Lord, have mercy.
Again, let us ask God the Pantocrator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind. Remember, O Lord, our assemblies blessed.
Pray for this holy church and for our assemblies.
Granted that they may be to us without obstacle or hindrance, that we hold them according to your holy and blessed will, houses of prayer, houses of purity, houses of blessings. Grant them to us, O Lord, and your servants who will come after us forever. The worship of idols, utterly uprooted from the world, Satan and all his evil powers, trample and humiliate them under our feet speedily, the offenses and their instigators abolish. Let the dissensions of corrupt heresies cease, the enemies of your holy church, O Lord, as at all times thou also humiliate, strip their vanity, show them their weaknesses speedily, bring to naught their envy, their intrigue, their madness, their wickedness, and their slanders which they commit against us. O Lord, bring them all to no avail, disperse their counsel, O God, who disperses the counsel of Ahithophel. Arise, O Lord God, let all your enemies be scattered, and let all who hate your holy name flee before your face. But let your people be in blessing,
thousand of God, begotten of Father before all ages, light of life, true God, begotten, not created, of one is the Father, by the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary became man, and Jesus Christ, first incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary became man, and Jesus Christ, first incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary became man, and Jesus Christ, first incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary became man, and Jesus Christ, first incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary became man, and Jesus Christ, first incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary became man, and Jesus Christ, first incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary became man, and Jesus Christ, first incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary became man, and Jesus Christ, first incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary became man, and Jesus Christ, first incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Of peace, a
thanks to the upon the lowly, who has created the heaven, the earth, the sea, and all that is therein, the Father of our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, by whom you have created all things visible and invisible, who is seated upon the throne of his glory, and who is worshipped by all the holy powers,
you are seated
before whom stand the angels, the archangels, the principalities, the authorities, the thrones, the dominions, and the powers. You are he around whom stand the cherubim full of eyes, and the seraphim with six wings, praising continuously without ceasing.
Salvation.
He granted us the birth from on high through water and spirit. He made us unto himself an assembled people and sanctified us by your Holy Spirit. He loved his own who were in the world, and as a ransom on our behalf, gave himself up unto death, which reigned over us, whereby we were bound and sold on account of our sins. He descended into Hades through the cross. And sat at your right hand, O Father. He has appointed a day for recompense on which he will appear to judge the world in righteousness and give each one according to his deeds.
According to your mercy, O
mystery of godliness, for being determined to give himself up to death for the life of the world.
We
He took bread into his holy which are without spot or blemish, blessed and life-giving.
We believe that this is true. Amen.
Heaven to you, O God, who are his father and master of everyone, and when he had given thanks,
Amen.
He blessed it,
Amen.
He sanctified it, disciples and holy apostles, saying, take eat of it, all of you, for this is my body, which is broken for you and for many, to be given for the remission of sins. This do in remembrance of me.
This is true.
Also the cup after supper, he mixed it of wine and water, and when he had given thanks,
Amen.
He blessed it,
Amen.
He sanctified.
Amen.
and gave it also to his own saintly disciples and holy apostles, saying, take drink of it, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many to be given for the remission of sins. This do.
Pray for the peace of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Orthodox Church of God.
Lord,
precious blood of your Christ, and all the Orthodox bishops, keep her in peace with all the Orthodox bishops who are in her foremost. Remember, O Lord, our blessed and our Father, the Archbishop, our Patriarch, Abba Thodros II, and his spiritual brethren, the Patriarch of Antioch, Mar Ignatius Ephraim II, and the Patriarch of Eritrea, Mon Antonius, and his partner, the Apostolic Liturgy, our Father, and the Bishop, Abba Youssef.
Seven orders of the Church of God.
Lord, have mercy.
And all the servants and all who are in virginity and the purity of all your faithful people.
Remember, O Lord, to have mercy upon us.
Have mercy upon us.
Cities, districts, islands, and monasteries.
Lord, have mercy.
And those who dwell there in God's faith, graciously accord, O Lord, to bless the air of heaven and the fruit of the earth.
Pray for the heaven and fruits of the earth, the trees, the vines, and every prepared fruit of the world. And first, thereby make us to bring into the passion and peace of the heart, and forgive us of our sin.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Give them all the heavenly reward.
Patriarchs who have fallen asleep, O Lord, repose their souls and forgive us our sins.
the Lord our God, the great, the eternal, wondrous in glory, keeping his covenant and his mercy to those who love him with all their redemption from sins through his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, the life of everyone, the help of those who flee to him, the hope of those who cry out to him. Thousands of thousands, and 10,000 times 10,000 holy angels and archangels, the cherubim and the seraphim, and all the innumerable hosts of the heavenly sanctified these gifts which are set forth through the coming down upon them of your Holy Spirit, you have purified them. Purify us also, our Master, from our sins, the hidden and manifest, and every thought which is not pleasing to your goodness. O God, the lover of mankind, may it be far from us. Souls, our bodies, our spirits, our hearts, our eyes, our understanding, our thoughts, and our consciences, so that with a pure heart and enlightened soul, an unashamed countenance, a faith unfeigned, a perfect love, and a firm hope, we may dare with boldness, without fear, to pray to you, O God, the Holy Father, who is in the heavens, and say, Our Father.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. One, in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Remember, O Lord, our assemblies, bless them.
Save them, mean, and with the Spirit, in the fear of God, let us attend.
Amen. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
The whole is for the holy. Blessed be the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Sanctification is by the Holy Spirit. Amen.
One is the Holy Father, one is the Holy Son, one is the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Irini pasi.
Ketonem pasi.
The Holy Body and the precious true blood of Jesus Christ, the Son of our God. Amen.
Amen.
The holy, precious body and the true blood of Jesus Christ, the Son of our God. Amen.
Amen.
The body and the blood of Emmanuel, our God, this is true. Amen.
Amen.
I believe, I confess to the last breath that this is the life-giving flesh that your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, took from our need, the Lady of us all, the Holy Theotokos, Saint Mary. He made it one with his divinity without mingling, without confusion, and without alteration. He confessed the good confession before Pontius Pilate. He gave it up for us upon the holy wood of the cross of his own will for us all. Truly, I believe that his divinity parted not from his humanity for a single moment, nor a twinkling of an eye, given for us for salvation, remission of sins, and eternal life to those who partake of him. I believe that this is true. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. I believe that this is true. Amen. Pray for us and for all Christians to us concerning God. Remember us in the house of the Lord, the peace and love of Jesus Christ be with you. Sing Alleluia. Pray for the worthy partaking of the Immaculate and Heavenly Holy Mysteries. Lord, have mercy.
Ah.
Sacrifice who is flying into the highest with his hymn. Remember us before the Lord that he may forgive us our sins.
Let us praise with the angels, saying, Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, and good will to the Lord.